Yo, what up, YouTube? We back again, and I just gotta say, man, I'm still here watching this video by Sanford the P, and this nigga was he was kicking some shit. You know, I felt compelled to donate $2 in the super chat, and it was I told him, hey, Lamar Wills is a pedophile, because as a matter of fact, this show topic is about pedophiles. Pedophiles, Lamar, that's you, bro. You know you're a child molester. You know you're a goddamn child molester. That's why your blood relative came on YouTube. That's why your blood relative came on YouTube and told everybody that you were a child molester. And like I said before, your homeboy Lester and your homeboy Chaos both, when they was asked the question, why was you being a child molester, they both said, I don't want to really speak on that because they know what you're about. They know what you're about, so that's proof of you a child molester. You're a goddamn child molester, bro. Also, something else I noticed too, Sanford the P, this nigga getting donations for $50 here, $20 there, $10 here, $5 there, $30 here. He getting donations and he's not even asking for them. He's not asking for them. That's because he got something to say. People really want to hear what he got to say, Lamar. When you get on YouTube, don't nobody want to hear what the fuck you talking about, bro. We don't want to hear it. And you on here begging and threatening people because you can't get donations. Simple the P on here just talking. I ain't hear him not one time ask for a dime. And people throwing money to him because, like I say, when you're not looking for it, that's when it's coming to you. Let it go. Let it go, Lamar, and it might come to you. But ain't nobody finna give you no money, because first off, you look dirty as fuck. You look dirty as hell. And like I say, Sanford the P is a pimp, and he is cooking your ass tonight, too. And like I say, whenever Sanford the P or Tariq Nasheed cook your ass, you ain't got nothing to say, but you will go cook people who are not even bothering you. You will cook folks who are not even bothering you, but when these niggas get on your ass, you go silent. Anyway, like I say, you call yourself some kind of a pimp, and you try to put yourself in the same weight class with Tariq Nasheed and Sanford the P. But one thing I can say, I never, not one time, saw Tariq or Sanford. Neither one of them. I never saw that. Need one of these niggas wear a long ass, tall tee, yellow, pissy yellow ass tall tee going down past his fucking hips. I never seen this nigga with fucking herpes on his fucking face, styes, all this. Man, you look dirty, Lamar. Quit talking that pimp shit. I guarantee you, the women that are Sinful and Tariq be fucking in the ass, you couldn't even get these women to look at you twice. A real woman look at you and she be like, she be disgusted. The women that you done been with, Lamar, them women that you been with, they ain't shit. Them old nasty ass, ghetto ass women. The women you got, you a real pimp. The women you got is nothing that I can't get or no other man can't get. The average nigga like me, a real nigga wouldn't even let now one of your baby mamas touch my dick. Couldn't no woman you ever been with touch my dick, Lamar. I wouldn't let her touch my dick. I wouldn't let now one of your women touch my dick with rubber gloves on, let alone stick my dick in her pussy and bust nuts inside her uterus. Hell no, that's a blessing. A nigga like me is a blessing to any bitch you done been with. More nasty ass women. But anyway, as I know, you ain't no pimp. The women you got is nothing special. And you ain't nothing special, bro. Also, I saw that video where you call yourself cooking me. When you were showing where, I guess what, you anyway, you reposted my video and you were showing your town. And you were driving around Benton Harbor. Let me tell you something, man. Benton Harbor looks like a fucking shithole. Nigga, Benton Harbor is a fucking dump. Don't you ever call me a country bum again, nigga. You live in that old nasty ass place. Let me tell you something. And the bad part is, Lamar, you grew up in that town. You grew up in that town, and not once have you ever said, you know what, I want more for my life. Let me leave this fucking town. That's why you so stupid in the fucking brain. You been in that fucking town for 44 years, never left, and people wonder why you fucking mentally retarded. People wonder why you dress like it's 2002. Man, Benton Harbor is a piece of shit town. I might go on Google Images and start taking screenshots and posting them shits. Cause that shit was disgusting, bro. Don't ever call me country or Obama again. Ever. Ever. Benton Harbor looked like somebody set off a fucking nuclear bomb in that fucking town. And you've been there for all them years of your life. And not once have you ever said, let me relocate. Let me get out of this fucking town. Never. And you so stuck, bro, that even when Sanford get out of jail, the nigga that popped your brother, when Sanford got out of jail, you still gonna stay in that town, trapped like a rat. That's sad. You ain't finna fight Sanford. You ain't finna shoot Sanford. You ain't finna mean mug Sanford. But you gonna be right there in that little bitty ass town. I bet if you drive 5 miles in any direction, you out of Benton Harbor. You out of that town, bro. I mean, anyway, that's why I can't take you serious, bro. When you be talking about me, talking about my life fucked up, I'm like, Lamar can't be talking about me. This nigga be talking about Kevin. That's why you lost your wife. You lost Michelle. This nigga, I don't think Lamar brag about his whole life that he get head. I don't know what woman finna let you pop your nasty dick in her fucking mouth. This nigga be bragging about getting head. And that's a childish ass mind. I get head, okay? So you was getting all that head from Michelle, but what do it matter? At the end of the day, Michelle still put you out the fucking house, bro. He put you out. She, Michelle, still put you out. After all them time Michelle that sucked your nasty penis, nigga, she still put your ass out. And now she's sucking somebody else's penis. So all you left with is the memories. We're back down memory lane. But yeah, you got all them goddamn memories and you sit up in the damn basement. Nigga, we call the folks homeless, but we know you in that basement, bro. Your life sucks, Lamar. And the thing about you, Lamar, is this. You can't change your life. Go. I talk about the laws of the universe again. The law of transmutation of energy states that at any given time, you have the ability to change your situation. You can take whatever vibration you in right now, and you can transmute and elevate that thing and change your situation as a human being. But guess what? You can't. You can talk all that shit. I'm up here chilling tomorrow. I'm admit. I took a step back in my finances, and I took a hit on some shit. But Lamar, at any given time, I could bounce back again and again. You can't. I don't even want to go into details, because a lot of y'all is just some fucking stalkers on YouTube. But for one, if you, like I said, when you try to go get a job, Lamar, people can look at you and you look disgusting. I would not let you represent no company of mine. I couldn't. You look disgusting and you look like a little piece of shit. If I had a restaurant, I wouldn't let you work at my restaurant, because you look unsanitary. You probably get a fucking customer's hepatitis or some shit like that. If I had a bank, I wouldn't let you work at my bank, because I believe you are steel with the most sticky ass fingers. If I ran a phone bank, I wouldn't even let you be a telemarketer for me, because you can't talk, and you don't have no fucking people skills, and your stupidity will show real quick. You illiterate, bro. You illiterate. So you talk all that shit like, yeah man, Kevin this and that. Kevin wife left, Michelle left. Kevin homeless, you in the basement. Kevin broke, you broke and you begging, bro. What else can I say? I mean, I could talk about you, nigga. And you got stretch marks, and you know what? I bet if you took off your shirt, nigga, I bet you got stretch marks like a fucking woman. I bet you got stretch marks like a woman, and I bet your nipples look like fucking look like big ass dollar pieces. I bet you got the big old nipples like a woman, nigga. You got a body like a woman. But anyway, like I say, man. You fucked up, bro. And speaking of people that's broken, dusty, Beasley, Gay Beasley, man, get the fuck out of here, man. Everything you do prove that you is fucking broke and you ain't shit. You another motherfucker. You never even been outside California. Be trying to call somebody Alabama, nigga. You ain't sophisticated. You a pussy. You a pussy. Matter of fact, I think I'm gonna make an unlisted video showing people what you really look like. For people who don't know what Beasley look like, if you saw what Beasley looked like, you would laugh. This nigga look like a little diabetic ass sissy. A weak ass man. He, man, this nigga weak as fuck. Beasley, if you see Beasley type of nigga, you a slap. You just slap that nigga off of first. Just as soon as you see him, you just slap that nigga. Like, I'm sorry, I don't know why I did that. This nigga just looked like his face was made to be slapped. You a little short ass, weak man, no muscles. You another Beasley, you got no muscles. You got woman hips too. Look like a little fat ass, little nerd. That what you was, a fat nerd. You another one of those fake ass niggas claiming you a pimp, bitch. Ain't nobody buying that shit, Beasley. Broke ass, dusty motherfucker. I would, and like I say, every time I cook Beasley, he flagged my video because the shit hurt his feelings. Beasley talk all that goddamn shit and the shit hurt his feelings. Nigga around here, hey Kevin, I just doxed your mom. I got your mom's paperwork. Okay, Beasley, guess what? I doxed your mama too. And guess what the survey says? That bitch in the dirt. That's right. That bitch is in the dirt. Stankin' ass nigga. Beasley, you need to go get a fucking life. Real talk, bro. Get a life, man. People tired of you. Don't nobody want to hear or see you coming. But you keep coming, nigga. And I'm going to tell you something before I go. I was listening to Pastor Geno Jennings' sermon some years ago, about 8 years ago. He had a sermon. He said this, and I'm taking this to heart, Beasley, because you're looking for love, bro. You're looking for love, but you ain't finna get it. Pastor Geno Jennings said this. He said, you can't make nobody love you, Beasley, but you can make them hate you. Same for you, Lamar. You can't make nobody love you, but you can make them hate you. Both of y'all niggas, y'all two most hated motherfuckers on this goddamn YouTube. Hated. And guess what, Lamar? That's why nobody donates to you. You too, Beasley. Do a live show and watch how many donations you get. None, pussy.